Okay, we're back. I'm straightening up a little bit there. Sorry, I should have done that ahead of time. The other camera won't run it. I don't know what it is. I don't think it's full. It could be. It has a smaller drive on it, but 32 gigabyte. These got 64, but it's got it had a little explanation point in the window. I don't even remember ever seeing that. And its battery's not down. It's halfway full. So have you got hot? So I'm going to turn both of them on. It's a good thing I had them both running. Okay, we're back. And I'm going to put the clamp downs on the everything back on the valve cover before I do anything else to try to figure out why it's not getting fuel. Cleaned up my hold downs for my valve cover, and the long and big thick long ones are chrome, just like the valve cover. They came with the valve cover, evidently. All that grease kept them out. They're not a bit of rust on them or anything. All that grease kept them nice and chromey under there, and I'm burning my leg. I'm sitting here trying to pick them up while I'm talking. This is one of those times of day that I like being on this thing. Right here. Okay, can't put anything up in there where I normally put it. And my butt can't sit where I normally put it. Okay. But I got all the grease wiped up and everything. So I can't tell where to put this. What am I? There we go. Oh, Lord, I didn't get all the, I thought I got all the crappy stuff off of that one, but I didn't. It's chrome. Looks nice. Okay, so the rest of it don't, because it's still dirty. It's got rust on it, though. But I got to get those loose again. Get my, at least my tools are still in the shade of my ladder. If that goes out of the shade, I don't know if it will or not. That goes out of the shade. I will be able to continue there, but I'm just going to try to get this done. And then if I can work around the sun, and I'm not burning it too bad, I'll keep going. Otherwise, I'll have to go away for the day. Don't let me forget to put my... I think I'll put the air cleaner on there. It gives me a place to lay stuff. And I can't drop anything in there by accident if the air cleaner's on it, because I didn't have any trouble getting to that before. Just gonna put the little nut on it too. So sometimes I forget to kind of put my hand on it. That's hot. Put something on the sun. Years past, I worked in this thing for hours with this hood being my only shade. I don't even want to do that kind of stuff anymore. Oh, okay. That one looks kind of short for its purpose. Wasn't originally for that either. But I've kind of got a mix smash of them. I can see that. Probably. Could have lost some and replaced them, you know. Don't have any of those long finger spinners. That's on here, that's for sure. Oh, that's exactly why I thought I shouldn't lay that up there. Went to pick it up with these stupid gloves, knocked it off instead of picking it up. Now, I think I already hit the ground. Talking about losing them, that's how you lose them. That's why I kind of don't put things over there because I knew better. Tools? Oh, usually that's okay. Hey, take the gloves off. I really just need them to get up and down now. This the other thing. I wouldn't have dropped it if I wouldn't have had this load in. Most likely. But the one I dropped is that little bitty short one. Maybe I'll go get another one that's a little longer. It doesn't look long enough to go through the, with that washer. It's one of those washers that won't come off. It doesn't look long enough to go through my little keeper. These, the ones in the top side are some I put on there. I'm sure they're factory style shorter ones. And these long bolts, yeah, I see them. They're matching long bolts. That's probably, I had to use them. And that big comb keeper is so thick that I probably didn't have enough to wash them. I think I'll go ahead and put those on there so that it doesn't move. That's the same length that it's got a washer, lock washer and a washer on it. That little short one looked too short to be in use, really. Oh, really knocked my camera off of there altogether. Guess it just kind of lifted up and went back down. I think it turned it. Can't even see where it's aiming anymore. There we go. It's aiming pretty much where I'm at. There we go. Just go down a little bit. Okay. This other one. I forgot that it was aiming way down there to look at the spark plugs. What the hell is it doing? Can't look at it with the hood. Probably where I can get my best view. And I had it all aimed on. At least I thought it would. Before I couldn't see it because of the way I was doing it. So. Those legs are kind of stay, but at certain points they kind of let go of that transformer. The other one won't do that at all. See, I'm using it on an uneven surface. I can close the leg up some to make it taller on that side. Okay, so, do the front one first, I guess. These both long. One's longer than the other. I can't see that one. That's, see about that one with all the washers on it? I think it might be longer. I will put the washers on there, I guess. Yeah, those two are the same length. So, I think I will put them in the long frame thingies. What do I call them? Long frame thingies. Put your knee on the valve cover because it will move it because it's not screwed down. Remember that. That one's in there pretty good. Gotta put them the right way. They have a big flip up on them. See how thick they are? They're pretty good. Of course, those valve covers are pretty thin metal. They're plated steel. They're not aluminum. I had some aluminum ones, I think, on something that were thin. I really like these. Okay, now I'm going to put that one right here in. I don't know if I'm going to need that lock washer or not. I think I'll put the lock washer on there because this is a pretty long bolt. Then I'll go get either another one or that one that I dropped. Yeah, it looks long enough with the washer. I can see this one good, so I'm going to get this one started. Can't see the hole, but the good thing they have those, you know, those little indentations on the valve cover so that you can get your socket in there. And so that tells you where the hole is, even if you can't see the hole. Okay, now I've got to go under the vehicle or else go, I guess I'll leave it there. It's going to get not much to keep things from falling up there. Not much there either. It usually falls. I put it in my toolbox. It's still shady over there.
Okay. Even my rag is getting hot.
Okay. I'm going to go see if I can find a quarter 20. I got some brand new ones, but those aren't strong enough for, you know, bolts for car, from engines are tougher than what you buy at the hardware store, so I don't use those. I absolutely have to. I don't know that I ever really did. Well, I don't know if you can see my, I did use that, but this is plated as to not corrode, and it's for my ground. But that is actually with some bolts I saved in the Telco, and they were plated with zinc or something. I don't know, it's gold looking. And they don't corrode very quickly. It's been on here 2 years, more, 3 years, and it hasn't corroded one bit. And I used it because I knew that, but also that's all I really had that was would work well. But that's where I put my ground, because that's hard bolted to the motor. Usually I always bolted it to the head or something, but I think there was just like no good way to do it or something. So I put it there. Because that alternator bracket don't ever come off, you know, you can't drive the car without an alternator. Anyway, it's worked really well. And that is softer, and it could break if you overstress it. So I put a wing nut on it so that I could take it off easy, instead of, because it's easier to take that off than the one off the battery. Haven't ever taken it off yet, but okay, let's go get another quarter turn from somewhere. I don't like that washer being up there. That fray is going to fall down in the engine or get in a fan in the alternator or something. I used to do that all the time, but also used to knock them off like I just now did. So maybe I'm getting older and wiser. Oh! I'll be back. This one back here now that I gotta open there. See my bolt. Well, if it's long enough, I guess there's no sense in looking for another one. So let's see how long it looks up next to the little deal that it goes through. But yeah, it has one of those permanent washers on it. Oh, it's long enough. That's why I used it. Alright, well let's just use it. I don't want to go digging through. It takes a while to find the right bucket over there. Right. Then they'll be dirty and have to be cleaned. I just won't need that washer. A lot quicker. I drink water though. You know, I'm noticing since I've been filming this whole project here, I tend to work myself harder. I'm always conscious that the camera's waiting on me to come back. And I even hurry when I get a drink of water and hesitate to go get a drink of water. That's kind of dumb, boy. You're just going to have to start waiting. But I just naturally do that, you know. I know somebody's waiting on me, so I try to hurry. My gloves up there so that they won't get too hot. Where'd I set that thing? Ow, burn. Hey, I can turn this sock right side out. Wrong side out. And we not. Oh gosh. Where did I set that thing? Oh, it's right here. I knew it was right there by something. Okay, yeah. All those wires in the room. Get out of the way. I meant to pull that off and kind of double check that it didn't have crap under it, but you know what? If it leaks, I'll know what to do. I will know what to do. It probably won't. But if it does, take it off, clean it up. If I have to, I'll put some, make a gasket on there, and if that don't work, I'll have to get a new gasket, new set. And you know what? These don't have to be all that tight. That's why I hold my wrench like that when I'm doing quarter 20s, so that I don't accidentally forget and overcut. I might do that just a little bit, just to hurt my wrist, but you get to there and it feels really tight, and that's about it. Unless you got some good reason. I'm not saying leave them loose, you get vibration, and of course you don't want your valve cover leaking. But one of the first fun things I did when my first car, I don't know if it's a 64 Chevelle, I remember working on it at 350 a megawatt. But, or it was a Buick Invicta, I don't know, it probably was a 64 Chevelle, I don't know that I ever had the valve covers off of that Buick. I wrecked it within a year, I don't know, I think of having it. Got hit across the Jacksonville Highway. But, put this on there. So anyway, I broke off quarter 20 and the valve cover bolts into the head. I think I broke a couple of them off. It took me a while to learn. Over the years, you know, I probably broke three or four of them in the first 3 years I worked on cars. I only learned to be more, don't torque the valve so much. Ah, but I didn't learn to remember things. What did I just say? Remind me to put that ground strap on there. Nobody said a thing. He just sat there laughing while I did this. He didn't tell me that I forgot the ground strap. I suppose that might be one cool thing if I was doing live videos like I do inside of my desktop. And there was actually able to monitor the chat somebody was monitoring it for me because I can't do all that at once. And they'd say, hey, you forgot the ground strap. That's easy to fix. I might need that. I'm going to need that washer. That washer. And I'm going to need to crawl. Why did I work? I think I'm getting tired. I want that washer because there's a big hole in that ground strip. Unless I put it under that metal thing. No, I don't want to do that. That'll stop it from going down flat on there and spreading out the pressure. I used to have a buddy that was a real good photographer. He didn't know much about cars at all. And I taught him how, you know, but he wasn't very mechanical, but I taught him how to change the oil and fuel filters and all that sort of junk. And he got to where he did that all the time by himself. But when I would go to help him, he usually didn't come out here, but I'd go to his house up in town. Sometimes we'd work on mine. He'd change the oil for me after he learned how. I wouldn't even have to do it. But anyway, he would hand me tools and hand me stuff I'd drop. So anyway, I need a helper. That's what I need. Especially now that I'm old and I can't get up and down good. I gotta crawl over here and get that damn thing. I don't even see it here. The little magnet wouldn't help it stick everything on the way down. You just gotta go get it. Nothing else to do but go get it. Get the door. I can't get out of here. The heat's making it harder. It's too hot to touch. With my anything but my gloves and that. I got a sock over the edge. At least, doesn't have to crawl under the truck to reach it. Sit on the board now. You can't sit on that edge. Keeping my little sock there just keeps from burning myself when I scoot over without thinking. It's hot fast when the sun gets on you. You don't want this on here first. You're going to put that, and then I'll put my round strap. Then drop it. Then I'll put my clear pan in with a washer. I think that'll work too. I don't know. I didn't have them all like that. I had that washer and lock washer on one of these. Probably this one. I don't know. But I want that to have plenty of thread to go down in there. So I think that's better the way it is now than the way I had it before. Hopefully, unless I knew something that I don't know about this one. Yeah, looks good. I meant to sand up that ground strap. It wasn't so rusty, but you know, with all the oil and stuff. I think it'll be fine though. The oil will keep it from being rusty, and all that pressure should make it look comfortable. It's rusty back there. I think it's alright. Especially since it's really oily. But I did mean to. Go ahead and sand it while it was off, but you know what, I'll do it when it's not so hot if I have any reason to believe it needs it. And as long as I don't forget all about it forever. Okay. Let's get this all over. See if I can get my light and look it over. Man, I can't see it. Any plug wires touching the headers or anything like that. Any of these wires on anything hot. I gotta take off the air cleaner one more time and look everything over. Oh yeah, if I'm gonna see why it's not getting the feel I need to have it off. Anyway, so there's solid full of fuel there. And now I shouldn't have a leaky anything, so let's see if I have my plug wires where they should be. Yeah, I guess that's alright. That intake gets kind of hot too. But that conduit, I always say the wrong thing. That stuff will pretty. It's actually not the cheap stuff like I have over here on these. It won't melt real easy, so I've never had it melt. I like it here. I think it's been laying there on that for all these years. Yeah, it has. I don't have any giant vacuum leaks or anything. Be something if that's what it was. It's I literally believe it's starving for fuel. The distributor's not loose. None of the wires on here are loose. Uh-oh. What's that? I had some tape on that. It has writing on it. What it said. I think it probably said negative. Did I not have any electrical tape? I must have done it so that when next time I got in there, I wouldn't say, whoa, there's a wire missing. It's probably for hooking up a pack or something. Oh, I see. There's actually a connector on there. Do I have a broken wire? Can't see from here. I'm going to have to crawl around. Let's see. Let's try looking from here first. I've got that phone mount up there. It doesn't have a phone on it. It doesn't stay in there very good. When you move it, the phone will run down if I don't have it plugged in. That's a connector. Did I just find something? The fact that it had the big piece of tape on it. Too bad of a place. I think I need to go around to the other side. It won't be as hot over there. The sun's not on that side so much. So, maybe I'll do that. I think I should take the other camera with me. What it is I've discovered, but I think I marked it so that I wouldn't think this goes there, but there's a connector with no wire in there. Female connector just stuck on the deal on the male connector. I remember always going around and around with it, but I don't remember exactly what was what. I know I rewired it. I can see that. I mean, kind of remember. First, I guess, get a drink.
What?
There's a nice breeze and I didn't even know it because I was in the sun. There's no sun on this side really. I think I might survive over here. There is right here by the tire, but I'm gonna be up on the hood. Well, there is right there in the front too. I don't know where the camera's gonna even be. That could be aiming at my area. Oh, where I was looking. Yeah. It's distributor. It's down low. I don't know if I can get this one up in there anywhere or not.
I'll hold it down there for a minute. It's up there. You see those, the red wire with the yellow connector? Well, onto this forward towards the camera, there is a connector that's no wire on it. And that's the one I'm wondering. I'm going to crawl up in here where I can really look. And I can't put the camera anywhere where I can see that any better than the one up on the front. So I'll just leave it. I guess I'll stop this one for a minute here. You know what? I'm doing this. I've done it before. The times when that's the only camera that anybody's still doing. Trying to figure out what I'm doing here. Yeah, see the back camera, you can see what I'm doing. Fidgeting or something. Yeah. Trying to figure out what to do. I gotta move that air cleaner because I won't be able to get in there myself. I'll just put it over here. Okay. Now there's a strap of sun right here. Ow, but it's not near as bad as the other side. Yeah, I can get my magnifying glass. If I need my light, it's right here. But the thing is, it's plugged into this camera. I had already decided it was good. Not a good idea to do that. And I've been using my extension cord. It's not that I really need a magnifying glass right there. Ow, I just need to look around real good for... any loose wires. Yeah, that's just a little connector on there. More light or not. Tack. That's what I was thinking. Okay, it says battery on this side and tack right there above that. But there's a lot more. Oh, there's more labels. Can't read them. Okay, B plus, ground, and C minus. And those other, the back one here has a special, you know, Chevrolet plug, and these others have regular. Well, actually, that one probably does too. So, tack. See, I don't think that matters. It's a negative. I wrote that on there, I think. See, I had to splice into these all these wires and put my own wire in there a few years ago. Because they were, they've been broke off and cut off so many times they weren't long enough anymore. Okay. So, don't think I have a problem with that. I think I put that label on there to try to tell me. I probably had more written on it, and was telling me don't worry about this. It's okay. I'm starting to wonder if my gasket sealer I put on there was wearing off and it needed more, but no. Because there used to be, a gasket, you know, paper gasket on the carburetor, and it got hard and wasn't really doing much good anymore. Then it broke into pieces. So I put that on there. That fuel filter's full of fuel, no problems, no leaking. Why should it have that tight? That gasket there is just squeezing out. But it's not leaking, so. And I sprayed a little bit of gasket sealer from days gone by. Oh, let's look in here and see if I'm getting the fuel right now. See if maybe there's a clog. Oops. See if there's a clog. That doesn't help. Maybe the light will help. See if there's a clog in there. Yeah, we're clogged up carburetor now. Now, as far as my noise goes, that wouldn't have nothing to do with it that I had, but the noise is gone now. Maybe that plug had died inside of itself and it caused noise because it wasn't firing. But yeah, there's fuel here. The carburetor's not putting neither one of the front jets and the back ones don't put any out that you can see unless it's running that I remember. They don't. They're vacuum secondaries. They're not hard linked. So that's why they're a little bit slower. They go whoop, just like that. Whoop. And they did work though when it was running. So I think my carburetor's clogged up. My carburetor cleaner that I sprayed in there. I thought, well, I'll spray some more in there and see if it'll run for a little while. If I can get right there. I'm really always leery of sticking my face. I've had them fire back in my face on them many times, and I get leery about sticking my face up there to look in them, trying to watch the gas, you know, where you. But it wouldn't run long for me to crawl up here a while ago. It probably won't this time, but let's try it again. I've got everything to where I can leave it and not worry about it, though. I've got the valve cover back on right and everything. So now. It's getting too hot. I'm gonna have to quit pretty soon. I'm getting to a good quitting point, I think. The best one would be when you've got it figured out. That just don't always happen. Found the lid from a carburetor cleaner. I think this time I'll spray starter fluid if it doesn't start up. Well, they're just coming back out. Let's see what happens. I'm going to try starting it. See if the carburetor is not squirting any gas, so there's fuel in the filter, but not coming out of the carburetor. I'm going to start it, maybe to run on that carburetor cleaner. I might spray some starter fluid in there to try to get it running again for a minute. get this cable out of the fan. I'm gonna unplug this thing for now. It is on a battery. Try to just do this. Shoot. It's all wrapping around it. Pissing regular flow now. I guess I set on that hose too many times. Never thought of that. Even if you're scared, look down the carburetor. Yeah, I'm gonna have to replace this hose. Me sitting on it broke it. It's too old for me to sit on it. I think it just got my pants soaked. Yeah, his pants are sopping wet. Broke it right here on the top. It's already unplugged, so I just right there. Started pissing underneath. I thought there was a hole right here, down here, where it rubs on the. Dang, there's almost a hole there, where it rubs on the. It'll sit there and vibrate on the fence rail, but that's the hole. I've been sitting on it, and it's old. I've done it all these years. I've always sat right there to work. Broke it. Okay, did I say the what I discovered? Put this all back together here before the battery ends up dying on this thing. When you give it a little gas, the carburetor starts dripping, not squirting a jet, but dripping lots of gas, enough to flood it and kill it. That's what it's doing. So I'm just gonna have to take the carburetor off and probably rebuild it again. I didn't hear all that noise. I'm gonna start it one more time and just listen to it. Just let it idle. It idles okay. It's when you try to give it. I couldn't understand why it would kept dying when I gave it gas. Carburetor sit around too long and got all. It could be just clogged up. But when you start really taking it apart, you're gonna end up probably breaking all the little gaskets in there. And I wouldn't want to try to use former gasket and all that intricate stuff in a carburetor, because you're going to clog up all the air jets and fuel jets. I mean, not jets, but transfer tubes inside the carburetor, transfer channels, however you want to say it. I almost started again. Let's see if it'll run long enough for me to kind of listen around on it. Chevy can rev it up and hit now.
Nothing. We figured out what two things are wrong though. The smoke a little bit of that oil. Yeah, that'll just have to burn off of there. Boy, that hose soaked my butt completely. Guess it might have been good that I had this sock rag in there to kind of soak some of it up. And a paper towel. Look at that. Probably saw it already on that camera. I don't know. I don't want to climb all the way back up there again. But, yeah, it's a good time to quit. Pants are soaked. It's too hot. Figured out something. Well, I figured out a couple of things. A suspicion that I might, it was probably a better idea to take the carburetor off and go through it, but I didn't want to if I didn't have to, and so you go through a lot of trouble trying to figure out what's wrong. Well, it seemed like it wasn't getting fuel, not that it was getting too much, so get your fat head up there and look, then you can. And then you can see whether it's getting fuel or not. Oh! Mr. Gloves! Where'd it go? It didn't go all the way down. See, you can't feel nothing with gloves. Even soft ones. You can't tell when something's starting. Look at that. How easy that is with your hands. This is why I never wore gloves when I was young. Hardly ever. But now I get all whiny about getting my hands dirty. Or they're tender and they hurt easy. Both. Well, it was super hot up here a minute ago. Now the sun's finally moving around. Okay. Stop this one, I guess, and the other one I'll finish up my end video.